I'm Alexis Van Hurkman, and welcome to Resolve in a Rush, where you'll learn DaVinci Resolve grading and finishing techniques in under 5 minutes. In this episode, I'm going to show you how you can save multiple versions of a grade associated with any particular clip. So if you find yourself in a situation where you want to try different things out, or you have a client who can't quite make up their mind, you can keep track of all the different versions of a grade that you create. So I've already got one grade set up. And if I decide I want to go ahead and experiment a little bit, I can right-click on that clip and choose local versions, create new version to create a new local version. I'm going to click OK. And now what's happened is DaVinci Resolve has automatically duplicated the grade that I had set up before to this new version. So I can use that as my starting point. So if I decide that I want to go ahead and maybe play around with the contrast via this curve a little bit, perhaps I want to warm up my midtones a little bit. If I want to go back to the previous version, I can either right-click right here on the thumbnail and simply choose version 1 and load that. Alternately, I can go up to the color menu. And the color menu also has a set of commands to add versions, command Y, switch back to the default version, which is version 1, and then I can move between the previous version and the next version, command B for before, command N for next. So in this case, I'm going to create one more version because the client wants to see what it would look like with simpler contrast. So I'll go ahead and reset this curve and just drop in a really simple S curve. So as I add all of these versions, I can now start using command B or command N to travel through all the different versions I have. But there's one other thing I can do. If I want to see all of the versions at the same time, I can turn on this second button from the left above the viewer. This is the split screen view. And by default, it will show me all of the versions in a grid. And in fact, there's also a setting for versions and the original. And this is going to go out to my hero display. So as I'm working with my client, if they can't make up their mind and they just want to take a look at all the versions we've created so far, I can turn this on and they can have a look, talk it over, and then you can decide which one you want. And you'll save these versions into the project and they'll just hang out. So as long as you need them, they'll be there. And at any time in the future, you can switch back. So versions are really, really useful. One last thing I'll show you, you can name versions. If I go into the submenu, I can rename any of these. So if I want to call this Cool Blue, I've now identified that version with a name. So there are lots more things I could do with versions, but those are the basics. And whether you're an editor keeping track of multiple grades or a colorist who's just getting started with Resolve, this is an important thing to know. I'm Alexis Van Hurkman. Thanks for watching.